Security, risk, and governance are absolutely essential for IT professionals in the enterprise today. We're speaking with Brennan Baybeck, who is the Vice President of Global IT Risk Management at Oracle. Brennan, how are you?
Great. Thank you, Michael.
Tell us about your environment.
So our environment is extremely complex. We're currently in a transformation where we're moving much of our IT infrastructure and IT systems to the cloud. And so we would be what people consider a hybrid environment, where we've got things that are still on-premise in our data centers that we own and manage. We have things that are definitely all completely cloud-based, and then we have things that are in the middle that are used to help us interface the systems in the different environments.
Brennan, share with us some of the practices that you follow that perhaps others can learn from.
So the practices that we follow that I think would be beneficial for people to hear about, one is it's the way we manage our threats and vulnerabilities at the company. We have a governance program in place for that where we are actively seeking information from all of our vendors. Oracle's a big one, of course, and understanding what the threats and vulnerabilities are to our environments, what they're doing in relation to their products to address threats and vulnerabilities. And alongside of that, we have a good asset inventory system where we keep track of all the assets so that we know what we have to patch and when, where the vulnerabilities should be applied.
Are there specific challenges that you face as you go through and try to execute this program you're describing?
Yeah, definitely the asset inventory at a large company like Oracle is a challenge. And all my peers that have companies of our size have the same challenges. The challenge there is that things are changing so rapidly that keeping those assets up to date, ensuring that they are automatically updated through automated techniques and things are what we're really looking for. Oracle's got a great program around that. They link the vulnerability information as well as the patching information, through that automation as well. So that's very beneficial to us.
Brennan, what's the relationship between these types of governance practices and the end result of having excellent security?
Having a good governance program gives you many benefits. The first one, protecting the business and the critical assets of that business. The critical assets, one of the main critical assets is the data. But if you're in a services business like we are at Oracle, good governance also helps drive compliance with contractual requirements with customers, regulatory compliance with regulators. Additionally, it also helps with ensuring that the various components of your security program are covered, whether it's security operations, change management, configuration management, patching, threat intelligence, whatever. Starting with that good governance program, those are what the benefits are.
You're describing, it sounds like, governance that covers both the technology deployment details as well as the processes.
Yes, and actually any good governance program should cover not only those two areas, the process and technology, but also the people. There's an old security saying that the people are the weakest link in the security chain. We still see that today. I've been doing this over 25 years, especially in large organizations with companies that are moving into DevOps processes and building security into those processes. It's more like a security education and making people part of the solution versus just sitting on the edge.
Brennan, you mentioned DevOps, and we hear lots of discussions these days around DevOps, but we don't hear too much about the role of governance and risk management in DevOps.
The role is actually changing quite a bit. In the past, you would see security risk people and governance individuals being kind of sitting on the edge as in a checklist type approach where the project would get done and then security and governance would come in and check some boxes and determine whether or not it's active in addressing the requirements that it's supposed to. In DevOps, that's a lot different. Things are iterating very quickly. Things are happening multiple iterations in a day. So the governance professionals and security professionals have to kind of rethink and retool and reskill themselves on how they're going to interface into those types of processes.
Well, of course, then I have to ask you, how will they retool and make sure that they're fitting into those kind of processes?
So as an example, what my team is considering and starting to work towards is, instead of being a person that is in there in the middle like a gatekeeper, we look to automation to do that. We look at making the developers responsible for implementing the proper security into their products and their services. And one way that we look at this is instead of it being a security vulnerability, it's now a defect in their code. So they know how to react to a defect in their code, which is, you know, they need to fix that. It's just like any other defect that they're working to fix in the next iteration. In the past, a security vulnerability would have been something that would ship off to a security professional to go look at, make an opinion on it, and then instruct that person to do a certain type of change. We want to get out of that role and in that process. What we want to focus on is creating the automation to allow them to move faster, create the value faster, and to enable the business.
Okay, Brennan Baybeck, thank you so much.
Thank you, Michael.